React is great. Svelte is great. Vue is great. Solid is great. You can't really make a bad choice. So then how do you differentiate yourself when you can't make a bad choice?
We were building an internal tool, and Miško was on this team, and he said, I can rebuild the whole thing in 2 weeks with this little side project I have.
I didn't quite make it, did I?
Not quite.
It took me 3 weeks.
We tried to talk to Google Maps, we tried to talk to Gmail. They were kind of like looking at what we were doing, like, yeah, this is a good toy, good luck with that.
If you are building a solution with developers in mind, friction has to be as close to zero as possible from the get-go, and AngularJS got that right.
Where you could just type in an input box and it would spell it backwards on the next line, and you could do that without any JavaScript, just HTML. That demo was something that the web had never, ever seen before.
We killed the controller.
Developers were pissed.
The messaging was always, it's just Angular, it's just Angular. And that wasn't true.
You are all liars.
Yeah, there's a lot to say about Ivy.
We didn't want to break the world again.
So we shipped Ivy, right? Party, celebration, woohoo. Except it wasn't turned on at Google.
We're all very aware of like people saying stuff like, oh, well, Angular's dead, and don't ever use Angular.
There was not a connection between their worth, their real worth, and people understanding that worth above. We can not invest, or we could reinvest.
One of the things that was very clear to us that we want to have a reactivity system that can be used anywhere.
Angular was being viewed as kind of a legacy framework in certain ways from the outside world, and he felt that we needed to do something to change that.
Angular and Wiz are going to be working together even more closely.
This convergence story, if all goes well, means that Angular will be powering Google Search.
The beginning of the new era of Angular, that's how I see it. It is really exciting to be part of it.